हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक विद द न्यू लेक्चर ऑफ क्लास 7 चैप्टर 1 इंटीजर्स। स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर सॉल्विंग एक्सरसाइज 1.2 एंड इन दैट वी आर इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 4। सो लेट मी रीड आउट द क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट। द क्वेश्चन 4 सेज फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स टू मेक द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स ट्रू। इन दिस दे हैव गिवन अस फाइव पार्ट्स, फाइव ब्लैंक्स in the statement form. We have to fill the blanks to make the statement, that is LHS is equal to RHS, true. Okay, so let us start. The first blank is minus 5 plus minus 8 is equal to minus 8 plus dash, that is blanks. Students, what number, which number we have to put here so that LHS becomes equal to RHS? Students, if you look carefully, it is the same thing which I have explained to you all in introductory lecture of exercise 1.2. Let me show you. It is commutative property for addition, where I have given you one example. 5 plus minus 7 is exactly equal to minus 7 plus 5. That is, if I write second number as the first number and then write this number as the second number, I will get the same result. Here also minus 2 and here also minus 2. That is, LHS is equal to RHS, it will become. Here also the similar number, similar pattern is given, not similar number, but similar pattern is given. Minus 5 plus minus 8 is equal to, see, minus 8 they have written first. Now what I have to write? I have to write minus 5. Why? Because we are using commutative property for addition. Let me show you by calculating also. Minus 5 plus minus 8 will give us minus 13. This side, minus 8 plus minus 5 will also give us minus 13. That is, LHS is equal to RHS. So we have made the statement true by putting minus 5 in the blanks. Now let us move to next question. Let me first write. Now students, second blank is minus 53 plus blanks is equal to minus 53. We have to add one number to 53, minus 53, such that we get the number minus 53. Here also students, we are applying the identity name is additive identity for integers. Do you remember, students? Let me show you again. Additive identity, you add 0 to any number will give that number. This was additive identity for integers. So here also we want the same number as the result. So what we will add? 0. See, minus 53 plus 0 is minus 53. Moving to next question, let me first write. Students, next question is 17 plus blanks is equal to 0. We have to put one such number such that if we add to 17, we get the result as 0. Students, this is very easy question. And for you all, whenever if one number is given and if it is in positive and you want the answer 0, you have to add the additive inverse of this number. What is additive inverse of 17? Minus 17. Now when you add two numbers with unlike sign, what will happen? 17 minus 17 will give me 0, right? So this was very easy. If the first number is minus 17 and the result is 0, students, then you have to take the additive inverse of first number. If it is minus 17, so here it will be 17. Okay, students. Now let us move to the next question, that is part 4. So part 4 is 13 plus minus 12 into bracket plus blanks is equal to 13 plus in the bracket minus 12 plus minus 7. Students, on looking this question carefully, do you remember the one of the property which I have explained you in introductory lecture? That is associative property for addition. In that, what we used to do, we used to group. Let me show you. In that, what we used to do, we used to group the three numbers. First, if I am grouping second and third number, then after equal to sign, I am grouping the first and the second number. Let me show you with example also. We have taken in that one example, minus 3, minus 2 and minus 5. And we are using associative property. First, I have grouped second and third number. And after equal to sign, I have grouped first and second number. And we get the same result, minus 10 and minus 10. Here also, if we see carefully, it is having the three numbers. But here they have removed one number as a blanks. They have given one number as a blank. But don't worry, on the RHS side, they have given us three numbers. So let us see, 13, here it is, minus 12, also there, which is missing, is minus 7. Now we will check if the answer is correct. Let us see. First we will solve this group. 13 plus minus 12 will give me plus 1. Plus minus 7 is equal to 13 as it is, plus I will group the two numbers in the bracket, and your answer is minus 12 plus minus 7, addition of two integers with equal sign. So we add and put the same sign. Now 1 plus minus 7 will give minus 6. In RHS, 13 plus minus 19 will also give me minus 6. Therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. Therefore, our answer minus 7 is right. Let us move to next question. It is fifth part. In fifth part, students, they have given us the same property. We have to use the same property. Here they have just changed the brackets. Over here they have grouped first two numbers. Here they have grouped second and third number. And blank is in the RHS side. See here, they have grouped second and third, and after equal to sign, they have grouped first and second. So students, without wasting a time, what will be our answer? See the three numbers, minus 4, minus 4, 15, 15. What is left? Minus 13. So that the statement will become equal. So I will write minus 13. Why I am using minus 13 without calculating? Because according to associative property, it is true. LHS will become RHS if I write minus 13. Let us prove by solving. Minus 4 I will write as it is, plus I will solve the two numbers in the group. 15 minus 13, 15 plus minus 13 will become plus 2. is equal to, now I am solving the two numbers in the group, minus 4 plus 15 will give me plus 11 plus minus 13. Therefore, minus 4 plus 2 will give me minus 2, and in RHS side, 11 plus minus 13, definitely there also it will be minus 2, because adding two integers with unlike signs, what we do, we subtract the numerical value and put the sign of the larger value. So subtracting 13 minus 11 will give 2, and larger value is 13, so I have written minus 2. So here also LHS is equal to RHS, therefore our answer minus 13 is true. That was all for today's lecture, students. Hope you have understood this lecture, question number 4. If not, please go through it 2-3 times so that you can understand it properly. And please follow the introductory lecture. Please watch the introductory lecture of this chapter. This exercise. We will meet again with the new lecture in coming days. Till then, take care of yourself, stay home, stay safe. Bye.